table. Our old dog, Barnaby, however, would always sit on Jesus' place. My sister said, this might be because he really feels that Jesus is with us.
Malinayan Pasko!
Say Merry Christmas, Anna!
So, a while back, before I was born, my dad flew out to California to spend Christmas with my mom. And he made her the scavenger hunt for Christmas. And at the very, very end of that scavenger hunt, there was an engagement ring. So, Christmas Day is my parents' engagement anniversary.
Merry Christmas.
Say Merry Christmas.
No.
What are you doing in my house?
Say Merry Christmas!
What?
Say
Merry Christmas?
Walter, can you say Merry Christmas? Can you say Merry Christmas?
If I could feel a memory instead of turning back time, all I thought the past was all that's left of you and I. I relive when we first met, when you caught my eye. The rush of us and all that was right now would be so nice, but I know when Christmas
Let's go. Christy Ebenhawk, and I'm the vocal director here at Grace Schools. I know that Christmas is a wonderful season for most people, but I want to tell you a little bit about a Christmas I had that was really challenging and just challenged me to think in a different way. This was 2002, over 20 years ago, and I was pregnant with my son, about 5 months pregnant. My husband had a friend from high school, and his name was Pat, and they have been friends for years and years, and Pat was having some family troubles and was staying at our house. He had four kids and had been married for years, but was staying at our house as he was kind of going through a healing time. He invited my husband, Kevin, to go with him on a trip to Hawaii to borrow like his parents' condo, and this was over the very beginning of December. my husband couldn't go. We had ultrasounds and all kinds of things during that time, and he wasn't able to go to Hawaii, which actually ended up being a really big blessing. Pat went away to Hawaii and went out into the Nepali area of Hawaii, out onto the rocks, and having an amazing time. He was with his two brothers, and there was an accident that happened, and it was a blowhole accident, and this blowhole blew up behind him and sucked him back down. He hit his head and ended up in the middle of the water and died tragically. His body washed on shore about an hour later in front of his brothers. And I remember getting the phone call, and I was pregnant. I was bathing my daughter at the time. And, you know, I didn't want to necessarily talk to Pat's wife because we were having a hard time, but I didn't know what had happened. She said, "Christy, Pat has died in Hawaii and I need to talk to your husband." And I handed the phone to my husband, and it was December 7th, and it was incredibly shocking, and it was just a really horrible Christmas. And I just remember thinking, I've got little kids, I'm pregnant right now, my husband is in complete turmoil, and this December does not feel like it's supposed to feel. It's hard. God, why are these things happening? Why would you take a dad away from his four young kids and his wife? Fast forward now into my life about 7 years ago. It's probably about 2015, and I'm teaching here at Grace Schools, and I'm standing at the door welcoming the kids into my classroom, and in walks a young boy and says, "Hi, I'm new to your class and new to the school," and he shakes my hand and he walks in, and I realize, oh my gosh, those are Pat's kids, and I hadn't seen them since they were little. I mean, they used to be my godchildren, and suddenly they're grown teenagers and they're walking into my classroom. And I called my husband on the break and said, "You'll never believe this, like, his kids are in my class." And we were both so surprised. And I walked outside, and there was a line of carpool moms and things, and here I run into Pat's wife. And mind you, way back when we weren't really speaking and there had been turmoil between the families, now we're waving to each other and hugging each other and saying, "It's been such a long time since I've seen you. How are you?" And here she is raising these kids and has now been remarried and had kids with her new husband as well. And our relationship has gone to a new place now of healing and forgiveness. And the Lord has taken something so incredibly broken and turned it into something so beautiful. And I got to now watch all of my godchildren, which were his children, graduate from high school and see all of the things that we would have seen had Pat been alive, but with the rest of the family. And I'm so thankful to the Lord for taking something so incredibly broken that I just didn't think was fixable and putting it back together into something amazing and just creating healing and forgiveness. And I will never forget the horrible Christmas that we had and the challenge of December. And every December 7th, I still look at that day and I now smile and say, "Thank you, Lord, for the time that we had with Pat." And Merry Christmas to you, Pat, in heaven.
Some good friends along life's way, some loved ones departed in heaven to stay, but thank God I didn't lose anything. Lost faith in people who said they time of my crisis, they were never focus and went astray. But thank God I didn't lose everything. I lost possessions that were so dear, and I lost some battles by walking in fear. But in the midst of my struggle, in my season of pain, one thing never wavered, one thing never changed. No, it never changed.
Looking past cold days. Do you like that light? A little spin here, a little curly cue to get me out on stage. Very nice job, Mr. Carter and all the tech crew up there. Doing a great job back there. Pretty impressive though. I love to see all that they're playing with the lights up here and the greens and the reds. Did you guys notice that? We redid the lights this year, and so it's like another toy for Mr. Carter to play with up there. But just so impressed with the talent that we have right here, or here on the stage tonight. Ooh, that didn't come out right. But so impressed with the talent to see, and what an amazing gift that they have. But that talent is really wasted if we don't have the leadership here to be able to make it happen. And so Mrs. Ebenhawk, Mr. Carter, Mr. Pate, Mrs. Saunders, what an amazing job. Can we give them a round of applause? What an incredible gift that we have as a school to have them lead our students. Well, it is Christmas season. Is it beginning to feel a little bit like Christmas? Maybe a little cool out, a little sweater weather. Christmas, the Cooper family loves the Christmas season. We love Christmas music, which is part of what I always enjoy coming to this concert each year, to hear the Christmas music. It gets you in the mood for Christmas. But Christmas music is, I don't know, and it's a controversial topic in the Cooper house, because the question is always, when do you begin to play Christmas music? The Cooper house, for me, I would say post-Thanksgiving. If you talk to my wife, she would say mid-July. That doesn't really fly, so we have compromised on November 1st, although this year my wife was sneaking it in October and we had to have words. But November 1st is what we settled on. I think part of it, my wife is from Minnesota. It begins to snow in Minnesota when you get out of July, and so maybe that's why it begins to, you know, feel a little bit like Christmas for her. But Christmas music, it's such a great thing. It's fun. It is kind of, you go, why don't we listen to it year round? It's such a great thing to sing about and to proclaim. But it always was interesting to me. If you listen, there's a lot of different types of Christmas songs. And some just talk about winter, some talk about snow, but a lot of them talk, and we get to sing them here tonight, they talk about who Jesus is, right? O Holy Night, Silent Night, Mary Did You Know? And it always blew my mind that some of the most famous Christmas songs have been sung by singers like the great Mariah Carey, or Bing Crosby, or Frank Sinatra, or some of these people, and you go, man, did they ever stop to actually think about what they were singing? Did they ever, when Pentatonix was singing, Mary, did you know that you were holding the God of the universe in your hands? You go, did they actually pause and actually ponder the words that they're singing? But I think that the problem is, to them, Mary, did you know is just another seasonal song. What I love about what we get to do here at Grace is, it's not just a seasonal song. It is a song about the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. We get to sing these songs, our students get to sing these songs to us, and we get to know and understand, our students get to know and understand what they actually really mean. Because Jesus was a baby. We sing about a baby that was born 2,000 years ago, but there's been lots of babies. So why sing about just a baby that was born on a manger, right? We sing Away in a Manger, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, because that's what happened. But we sing about Jesus in a manger because he was different. He was different because this baby did not just have angels proclaiming his birth, but this baby grew up and made incredible claims about who he is. He said that he is the promised one. He is the Messiah. When you have seen me, you have seen the Father, he said. He said that I am the light. He made those claims, but he didn't just make claims, and a lot of people made claims over the years. We've heard a lot of people on the news today make claims, but what's so special about them? But Jesus actually went, he took his life and he bore our sins on the cross. He died on the cross for us. He died for what he believed in, but there's been a lot of people who died for what they believed in. A lot of people have died for causes, but there's only been one person in all of history who died and then rose again on the third day. And what we get to celebrate as we sing about this baby Jesus, we get to sing about the Redeemer who rose again on the third day. And as our students get to sing it to us, as we hear those words don't ring hollow. Those words aren't just like, oh, a cute little fun folksy song. Those words are songs about our Savior. What a blessing that we have at Grace to sing these songs and to sing them completely during this season. Well, I'm so excited for this next song because it's one of my absolute favorites. And so as we do, let me just say this. Listen to what these three guys up here have to say. Listen to what they have to say as they sing about that they have seen the light. It's not just a little light bulb that turns on for them, but they've seen the light because they know who our Savior is. It is gonna be, it's a song, last night, it's one of my favorites, and last night I got goosebumps, I got chills as they sang it, and I hope you guys get to enjoy it too as we sing about the true meaning of Christmas. Well, hey, Merry Christmas, everybody. Can I get a Merry Christmas? Merry Christmas, and let's enjoy this last song as we get to enjoy our students. Thank you.
Through the shadows, delivering the dawn. I have seen the light.